Kia ora, Sam.
Morena, Charlie.
What's up, Sam? You look stressed.
Traffic's made me really late. Again. Might need a triple shot today. I wish there was something I could actually rely on.
Well, you can rely on your daily caffeine fix.
But how can I be sure? Like, what happens if the power goes off?
Yeah, that's one of the worst things for us cafe owners. Luckily, New Zealand has one of the most impressive electricity systems in the world.
Fascinating.
No, seriously. A lot goes on behind the scenes so you can turn the lights on or crank up the espresso machine when you want to.
Okay.
No, really, it's pretty clever. Generators transform energy from things like hydro, wind, geothermal, gas and coal into electricity. And that's all sold and bought on a market.
Like a farmer's market?
Kind of. Like veggie prices, the cost of electricity depends on the source, the time of day and where and how much it's used.
Is that my coffee?
No, won't be long though. As I was saying, the whole system is designed to meet our needs at peak times.
What do you mean by peak?
When we use a lot of electricity as a country, like during mealtimes, or at 6 p.m. in the winter, or when the ads come on during the Rugby World Cup final.
Okay, but how do we know the system can handle everyone watching the game at the same time?
Lots of ways. Companies have to follow rules and carefully manage risk to keep the power flowing. Then there's Transpower.
Who?
You know, they run the national grid, and they're in charge of the minute-by-minute running of the wholesale market.
I see.
To match supply and demand, they release the cheapest generation first. And when there's heaps of demand, they release power from more expensive sources.
I'm starting to get it. About my coffee?
Almost ready. But get this. New Zealand's electricity comes mostly from hydro, from running water through turbines. The hydro lakes act like batteries because they store water until it's needed.
That is pretty cool.
Yeah, it is. But when there's not much water in the lakes, hydro generators produce less electricity and the price rises. This helps to protect the water levels and means other generation is bought in its place.
So the price helps protect our power supply.
Sure does. And worst case scenario, if we get dry weather and the lake levels get really low, a conservation campaign is launched and we're all asked to use less electricity. There are costs to companies if that happens too, so they work really hard to avoid this. It's all written into the rule book. There's also a thing called stress testing.
Stress testing?
It's a good thing. It's just an extra precaution so your power company can prove they're financially responsible and can handle the highs and lows. Remember when they did actually ask us to save power years ago?
Oh yeah, that was when we had like hardly any rain.
Exactly. That's when the Electricity Authority was created and they brought those rules in. Since then, when we've had those dry seasons, our power supply's been sweet. And here's your coffee.
Oh, cheers. Well, that was actually really interesting. How do you know all this stuff anyway?
I read it on the internet.
Amazing what you can learn waiting for a flat white.